We have Sreeharsha, who works with the Kisan Mitra helpline. He is a social activist, works on environment rights, and open source enthusiast. He is here to talk about how we can understand rural distress. Over to you, Sreeharsha.
So whom do you think of when you recollect, when you think of a farmer, whom do you recollect? In majority, it is probably a farmer with a turban, this kind of thing. So, but you see all the women farmers who toil most of the thing, they're kind of not present in any of the data, but they do 75% of the work. So it's the state of data, right? So hence it is very important to understand it from various angles and from the field. So hence my respect to all the women farmers who have been toiling day in day out. I'm Harsha. I work with the Kisan Mitra helpline. It's a rural distress helpline. I'm also part of a community called Rythuswarajyavedika. It works on rural farmer distress and also on prevention of suicides. So this is a farmer suicide map in Telangana, a district-wise map. If you see all the hotspots, they are the most number of suicides which have happened. So this data is actually scrapped from newspapers every day by volunteers across the state from district-level papers. And then it is by WhatsApp groups or various other things shared within the groups. And then these are entered into Google Sheet, and then field visits are done by various people, which are again volunteers or teachers are prepared, and then verify and how they can support it, and all those things are then followed up. This data, because the NCRP data, which is supposed to be official data, is not being released by the government for many years. This is one of the only data which exists in Telangana. It has been also quoted in the parliament and various other sources also. So with this, so that is the state of the suicide data. So if you see the hotspots, a few characteristics are, most of these are cotton belt, most of these are rain fed, and mostly there is no institutional support for these in these areas, especially in between if you see, right? All the very dark red patches and above and below if you see. These are all mostly cotton belts. These are some of the how we engage with our field in various tribal areas and also a few farmers, suicide families. The other thing we need to understand is if you think of huge categories, farmers in themselves. In Telangana, we have noticed that this is a study done along with tests recently. We have seen that 75% in the out of 600 farmers, when we went deep and analyzed, we saw that 75 farmers are tenant farmers who have committed suicide. For example, if you see the last column, the Sadilabad district, 87 out of 87 suicide, 75 people were tenant farmers. Tenant farmers are like how we have tenancy here in our place also. So they don't have any rights, they just take lease, they pay actually lease, and if they have crop loss, they don't have anything else also to support. So yeah, so this is another data point. Zooming in, this is one district in Adilabad. This is the data for last month of suicides. If you see on the right, we have one interesting aspect we came across is that's interesting with the field, right? One randomly we came across one person who was being rushed to the hospital, and then we reached the hospital, you know, including field, the police records and all. We saw that there were many more suicide attempts which were not even covered in the papers. So for example, in Adilabad, mostly you'll see in the papers who have committed suicide and who died. But if you see, there are 40 more people who attempted suicide. So when we are actually trying to find distress, so these are also people whom we need to actually talk and understand, because the people who are alive, and also who need support, who need to get out. So if you see the bottom most area of Utnur, where are 6 number of suicides. The other interesting aspect, very sad aspect is, it's mostly dominated by tribals, especially Golds, and Lambadas are also there. So these are communities which are very resilient and have their own culture. But if you see in the last few months, you have seen that is also that the number of suicides also been increasing. And sadly, that is also because of probably the floods which have hit Adilabad a few months back, but also various other issues of monocrop and all these things creeping in. So on this endeavor, we started off the Kisan Mitra helpline. So we currently function in three districts, Adilabad, Mansirial and Vikarabad. We work with district administration on improving the governance as well as proactively and reactively working on issues. Proactively work on policy and other issues by understanding data and other things. Reactively, any distressed farmers reaches us, help all these things. Work with the government, if not work with outside and make sure this farmer doesn't go to the suicide. That is the worst thing. Or else, how can you reduce the distress? We also, for example, one of the data points you see is I want to talk about crop loss especially. Yeah. So if you see, we were hit with a lot of farmers calling us from Vikarabad because of red gram loss and various other things. So if you see the area of this plotted, it is the amount they would receive for insurance cover, right? If you see the dark spots which are there, that is the area which is severely affected. A few things which we thought we'll also work on, because we are still trying to incorporate OSM and various other things into mapping rural assets. Thought will help in the local governance and various other things. Land and forest rights is very important. For Kisan Mitra itself, for example, the industry administration and various other people go out to the field, they will know various issues which are there and there. So it helps the map as a base also. Seed diversity, because seed is very much inbuilt in the culture and very across location it is distributed. So understanding that it is very core and similar to the open source principle, seed in itself. So I believe that is something we need to mostly work on. Soil, there is a lot of data which is existing but not being analyzed. Groundwater and all those things are also not mapped. So I believe tribal population, the culture and all this. These are a few areas which we are looking forward to work on. Yeah. So. Looking forward, you can come over. We have a few of our friends also from there. We can discuss. Yeah, I don't have my contact. My Twitter is nanohasha, NanoHasha. Thanks.